He's back! Oh, man. So, this episode, there are points where I liked it and points where I didn't. Let's talk about the stuff I liked. Space Tow Truck. Why isn't that a show? Because I would watch the shit out of that. Anyway, so, the big point of this episode, of course, is a certain return of a few villains, including a certain someone's favorite villain. We'll get to him in a minute. I could have worded that joke better. Anyway, but yeah, it's Bubbles. It's another Bubbles episode, and we have basically Blossom and Buttercup taking this way too seriously, and the end result is that Bubbles at this beauty pageant doesn't want to sing, and it upsets her, and shenanigans ensue. Now, the big thing with this episode is that the big thing with this episode is obviously the return of some certain villains. We get Mojo back, we get Princess back, you know, we've seen them before. But this is also the return of the Gangrene Gang and Fuzzy Blumpkin. I mean, Bumpkin. That name's not going away. Oh, that was... Oof. Yeah, so, I'm not going to be able to say it, so I can't say, Bumpkin without going Fuzzy Blumpkin, which I'm pretty sure in some establishments would be called a number four. Anyway, I'm just gonna call him Fuzzy, because now I can't resist the urge of saying the whole damn thing. Whatever. So yeah, Fuzzy, the Gangrene Gang, we got the original voice actors back. I'm kinda still bummed that we didn't get Jennifer Hale to come back to do, Princess, but apparently the showrunner is the... I didn't know this until earlier this week. I didn't realize this, but apparently the showrunner of the new series of Powerpuff Girls is the new voice actress for Princess. Not to say she's bad. She's actually, you know, she's pretty good, but at the same time, I'm wondering, why didn't you just get Jennifer to do this? Because I feel like, I mean, you've kind of taken out... We still don't know if Seduce is coming back. We already wrote out Miss Bellum. So, come on. Anyway. And of course, we get the return of him. Yes, and I was so... Like, the moment I saw that they said Tiara of Unknown Origin, I was like, is him behind this? And sure enough, him is behind this. And they didn't change a damn thing about him, and I love it. Tom Kane is back. He sounds like he hasn't left, you know, he hasn't missed a beat. Same with all the other original voice actors. You know, Jim Cummings comes back as Fuzzy. You know, we've got the original Gangrene Gang members again. Well, actually, I think only Ace talked. I don't think Big Billy or the others didn't. I don't think they talked either. I don't think they talked. But, yeah, Fuzzy and Ace, their voice actors came back. And, of course, we had, Mojo's original voice actor come back. And, yeah, him is played once again by Tom Kane, who, has, like I said, hasn't missed a beat. I know I sound really excited for seeing him again, because, for those who don't know, him is my favorite cartoon villain, not just in Powerpuff Girls, but in general. Probably one of the most terrifying things ever, and thank God they didn't change the design at all. They still kept him this transsexual crab demon, you know, yay. Because that design is so out there and so unique, you'd have to keep it. And him's whole thing is that he's just here to be a dick. And it's not like, oh, he's done world-destroying plots before. But this time around, it's more like, I'm just here to cause trouble. Which he's done in the past before. Sometimes he'll just do stuff to be like, yeah, I'm going to just do this for the hell of it. And that's kind of the point, is that he just really... He just had the point of doing this for shits and giggles, which, yeah, that would be it. And using this tiara to possess Princess to make her into literally something out of Danny Phantom was fun. Also, I don't know if this is true or not, but I think the girl singing, I think it's the same voice actress for Bubbles who did the singing for Bubbles in this episode, but I think it may be someone else, if I'm not mistaken. Comment below if anyone knows that to be true or not, but yeah. This episode was alright. I didn't like how the sudden change between Blossom and Buttercup just to get back at Morbucks. At least this episode doesn't feel like a retread of another episode. I'll give it that much, that this episode doesn't feel like a total retread of a previous episode like we've been getting for the past three episodes. So, I will give it that. And, of course, it's nice to see him again. Of course, seeing the gang, Green Gang, and Fuzzy, they're all back and hearing their voice actor, their voice acting. And I also kind of laughed at what Mojo really wanted to do with the tiara. And I was like, yeah, Mojo would probably do that. He probably would. Also, I dug there's a brief Amadeus reference. I was like, no one's going to get that unless they saw that movie. Which I did. Anyway. So, I enjoyed this episode. I didn't really care much, Buttercup seems to be the deadpan straight girl in this show. And what I mean is, she's probably the one who's probably going to be thinking all the logic, but just keeps to herself, and just... She's going to be kind of like a superpowered version of April from Parks and Rec. That's what I'm probably thinking, is that they've decided to make Buttercup the superpowered version of April from Parks and Recreation. Yeah, I'm not the biggest fan of Parks and Rec, but, yeah, it's alright. Anyway. So, yeah, not much else I can say other than this is a pretty decent episode. So you guys tell me, what did you guys think of this episode? Did you guys like it? Did you guys hate it? What did you guys think of the return of Fuzzy, the gang, Green Gang, and him? Just comment below, let me know, and once again, hope you all enjoyed this, and I will see you guys later.